Hello everyone, let's start with question number 6, exercise 3.4. So this is from NCERT example and it is given here that Ankita travels 14 km to her home partly by rickshaw and partly by bus. She takes half an hour if she travels 2 km by rickshaw and the remaining distance by bus. So from the first we can find the equation. And here we need to find the speed of rickshaw and speed of bus respectively. So I will take speed of rickshaw as x and speed of bus as y. Now in this it is given that she has to cover 14 km. That means we know the formula of speed. Speed formula is speed equals distance over time. Now I want it in the form of time. So it will be distance over speed. So this is distance over speed. Now in this case, we have time as half an hour. So half an hour needs to be get converted into minutes. So it will be, it won't be get converted into minutes. It will be same in hour. We need to keep it as half only. And the speed of rickshaw is x. So distance is for rickshaw distance is 2. So it will be 2 over x. Then for bus it is 12 over y. How 12? Because she had already covered 2 kilometers. So 14 minus 2 is 12. 12 by bus and 2 by rickshaw. So it is 2x plus 12y equals time. Time is half an hour. So it will be half. This is equation number 1. Now we need to write the second equation. So in this it is given that on the other hand, if she travels 4 km by rickshaw and the remaining distance by bus and she takes 9 minutes longer. So the equation will be like this. 4 over x plus remaining distance. Total distance is 14, 4 has been covered by rickshaw, so 14 minus 4 is 10. 10 over y equals she takes 9 minutes longer. Matlab 30 minutes ke baad 9 minutes aur lag rahe hain. Iska matlab kya hua ki hume kya karna padega 9 minutes ko hour mein convert karna padega. So it will be 9 over 60. So half plus 9 over 60. So this will be, we need to take LCM of this, so it is 60 only. I need to multiply the first term with 30. So it will be 30 plus 9 over 60. It is 39 over 60. And the equation is 4 over x plus 10y equals 39 over 60. This is my equation number 2. So now we have two equations. And we need to find the value of x and y respectively. So in this, what we can do is we can use the reducible form. In reducible form, what we need to do is we need to let 1 over x as a and 1 over y as b. So my equation 1 becomes 2a because why? We have 1 over x here. So 1 over x can be replaced by a. Now in the second part, it will be 1 over y. So it will be plus 12b equals half. This is my equation number 3. Now changing second equation, it will be 4a plus 10b equals 39 over 60. Now we need to solve equation number 3 and 4 to find the value of a and b. So using elimination method again, what I need to do is I need to make this term and this term same. So for that, I need to multiply third equation with 2. So it will be 4a plus 24b equals 1. Why 1? Because 2 into half is 1. Now the fourth equation is 4a plus 10b equals 39 over 60. Now we need to subtract the equations 3 and 4. So changing all signs, we get 4a subtracted 4a equals 0. Then we have 14b equals 1 minus 39 over 60. So 1 minus 39 over 60 will be 21 over 60. Now using cross multiplication we get 21 over 60 into 14. Now we can cut down the values 21 and 14 with the help of 7. So it will be 3 over 2. Now we can cut 3 with 60, so it will be 20 here. So 1 over 20 into 2 is 1 over 40. B value is 1 over 40. Now we need to find the value of A. So I will use equation number 3 to find the value of A. So it is 2A plus 12. B is 1 over 40 equals half. Now we get the value of 2A. 2A equals half minus 12 over 40. Now we can reduce 12 over 40 as 6 over 20 and further by 2 again. So it will be 3 over 10. So now what I need to do is we need to take LCM of it. So it will be times 5 for the first term. So 5 minus 3 over 10. 2a, so it will be a equals 2 over 10 into 2. 2 and 2 gets cancelled out and we get the value of a as 1 over 10. But we need to find the value of x and y. So you can see if I put the value of a as 1 over 10, so taking when we use cross multiplication, we get x as 10 and for y, it will be 1 over y equals 1 over b, it will be 1 over 40. So y will be 40 km per hour and x will be 10 km per hour. So that's your solution for question number 6.